This video is transformative in nature. Any gameplay and commentary displayed in this video should be considered covered under fair use law. This game is rated M for mature. Viewer discretion is advised. Hey there, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Persona 5. In the last episode, well, we did a whole bunch of stuff, actually. And in this episode, we're gonna probably continue to do more crazy stuff. But right now, I think it's time we just go to bed.
Well, then.
I like the change in sleep attire. We get like a whole new set of sheets and everything. It's pretty great. And our approval rating has doubled, which is pretty nice.
Mr. Akechi's coming on.
Ah, it's Akechi!
Oh, he's so cool.
Isn't that the guy from yesterday?
Cutting back from commercial. 7, 6, 5 seconds till start. 4, 3.
And now, on to the hottest meet and greet segment of our show. After his last appearance was so well received, we decided to bring back this fine gentleman today. It's the high school detective, Goro Akechi.
Hello there.
Thank you for taking the time to join us today, Akechi-kun. Your popularity is stunning.
Even I found it to be quite a surprise. It is a bit embarrassing, though.
Was this the segment from the trailer, or am I crazy? No. Well, I saw the trailer in Japanese, so it could be, but I don't think so.
Moving along, we've been told there's a case on your mind right now. Care to share, Detective?
Ah, yes. That would be the scandal involving the master artist Madarame.
There it is! All of this Phantom Thief excitement has caught your attention too, Akechi-kun!
Oh, it seems like we caught his eye.
Allow me to be blunt for just a second. What do you think of these justice-oriented Phantom Thieves?
If they truly are heroes of justice, I sincerely hope they exist.
Oh, so you don't deny the possibility that they're real?
I may not seem like it, but I sometimes wish that Santa Claus actually existed.
I guess he's more of a kid at heart.
Although, if he did, I'd have to arrest him for breaking and entering. But, hypothetically speaking, if these Phantom Thieves are real, I believe they should be tried in a court of law.
That's quite the statement. Are they committing crimes? Some people even say that the thieves are actually helping their victims abandon their evil ways.
What the artist Madarame did truly was an unforgivable crime. However, they're taking the law into their own hands by judging him. It is far from justice. More importantly, you should never forcefully change a person's heart.
You have a point. These people are calling themselves the Phantom Thieves, after all. Amazing as always, Akechi-kun. I could listen to you for days. You have the most radiant charisma.
So what's your ideal of justice, then?
I have to say, though, I would be embarrassed if it turns out these Phantom Thieves don't exist.
Because my whole thing is, I think it's worse to do nothing than it is to force a change of heart. Because is it really forcing a change of heart? We're just removing a distorted desire. But he doesn't know that. I don't think he understands how this works.
If that were the case, I'd summarize it into a report as a school project.
Now then, let's try asking some students the same age as Akechi-kun about the Phantom Thieves. First, please press your button now if you think the Phantom Thieves exist.
Of course they do.
About 30% or so. What are your thoughts, Akechi-kun?
I'm a bit surprised. That's higher than I was expecting. I'd love to hear some more detailed opinions on the Phantom Thieves' actions.
Oh, don't pick me. Please don't pick me. Oh, no.
Let's try asking this student here.
Oh, boy. You just chose the leader of the Phantom Thieves to ask a question about the Phantom Thieves.
Hypothetically speaking, what are your thoughts on these Phantom Thieves if they were real?
Well, they're justice itself.
You say that with such firmness.
This completely goes against the opinion you had about them being tried by law, Akechi-kun.
Indeed. It's rather intriguing to hear such a strong acknowledgement. In that case, There's one more question I'd like to ask. If someone close to you, for example, your friend next to you, if his heart suddenly changed, wouldn't you think it was the work of the Phantom Thieves?
What would you think?
Ah, throwing the question back at me. Well, this is my opinion on the topic. Whether the thieves' actions are good or not, I feel there is a more important issue at hand.
What do you mean?
The matter of how they change people's hearts. If they honestly possess that ability, it could be used for more than extracting confessions. It could be that what seem to be ordinary crimes are actually being perpetrated by these methods.
You know, you're absolutely right.
Oh, please don't misunderstand. This is all purely hypothetical.
The means, huh?
It is only if people who can use such a power truly exist. Either way, though, this cannot be ignored. The existence of the Phantom Thieves would be nothing but a threat to our everyday lives. To be honest, I'm already working alongside the police to help sort out this matter.
He made us seem like villains.
It kinda seemed like what he was saying might be right.
He made it sound like we're the baddies. I don't like it.
That stuff about the police, do you think it's for real?
He can say whatever he wants. The justice of it all is something we can decide for ourselves.
That's true. But is it really our place to put justice in our own hands? Isn't that basically the same thing as being a vigilante? I don't know. You know, he's really making me question if what we did was right.
Oh, sorry, I gotta go take a leak. Can you guys wait here? I'll be right back.
Oh my god, I'm gonna keep going, okay?
Wow, Anne, come on.
Oh, it's you.
Hey there, detective boy.
I'm glad I found you. I wanted to thank you in person. To paraphrase Hegel, advancement cannot occur without both thesis and antithesis.
Nice quote.
My apologies. What I mean is that our discussion was quite meaningful.
In more ways than you understand, friend.
Few people around me are so willing to speak their minds as freely as you did earlier. Adults are only interested in using the young. All they simply do as the adults say. I feel like our discussions could prove quite fruitful. Would you mind talking with me again?
Well, if the opportunity arises.
Thank you. It makes me glad to hear that. The students from Shugen are truly quite interesting. I look forward to seeing you again. Well then?
Well, see you later.
Talk about a problematic guy to get involved with.
Yeah, we basically just got involved with our own worst enemy.
There's probably a lot we can learn from him, though.
Some good targets, maybe? No, wait, is that actually a social link? Oh my god, I was not expecting that.
I can't believe you evaded the police's network until today. The only logical explanation is that someone in the police has ties to the Phantom Thieves. Explain yourself.
I am thou. Thou art I. Thou hast acquired a new vow.
I can't believe we ended up getting in bed with our worst enemy, though.
Of rebellion that breaketh thy chains of captivity.
I mean, is he even our enemy? I don't know. This is confusing.
The justice persona, I have obtained the winds of blessing that shall lead to freedom and new power.
Huh. Justice. I wonder what we get out of that one.
All right.
I'm also wondering if that's story related. Because I actually really like the Justice Arcana.
Sorry for taking so long. Wait, was that a catchy? I can't stand that high and mighty attitude. Just breathing the same air as it makes me sick.
Calm down, Ryuji.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, unfortunate for us. I mean, it's true. We are Phantom Thieves. Great. Yeah, see, I'm in the same boat as these two. I think that even though we may have done something that didn't that wasn't necessarily justified, I think that what we did still needed to be done, even if it wasn't, like, necessary to be done, if that makes any sense. I'm just kind of talking in circles, it's a bit late at this point, but morally, I don't think we did anything wrong. Actually, I honestly think we're helping people. Yeah. Who could this be? I think he's getting angry because we personally saved him and everybody else from a horrible dictator. And, you know, he kind of feels like if we did something wrong, that means helping him was wrong. And I don't think that's wrong at all. Alright, can't wait to see what it changes to. Hey there, old man. Yeah, he's fine. Endure the summer heat, huh? It's probably an anti-fire item. Not bad. Alright. Can we actually do anything today? Yeah, you know what? Why don't we call Kawakami over? Yeah, let's give her a call. Oh, well, it's gonna cost me, but I don't mind. Sure. Let's call her over, even if it doesn't do very much. Wait, don't I have a temperance link? Isn't she temperance? Or is her social link gonna go up? I don't even know. I guess not. Oh, maybe I do have one then. Alright, perfect.
Thank you for using our service.
I guess that worked out well enough. God, this is gonna be the most expensive social link. Were you watching the broadcast? So the Phantom Thieves were the bad guys? I guess now that you mention it, I felt that way the whole time. It's just brainwashing, isn't it? It's really self-centered. Ugh. Now I'm kind of pissed. Hey, look at that! We actually ended up getting a little bit more belief. Are the Phantom Thieves just? Oh wow, look at that. He did change up the question. And we've got more of an approval rating. 18%, huh?
The Phantom Thieves are super lame!
Oh my god, really? What a voice line. Of course not. Supernatural happenings are really hard for people to believe. We're probably gonna have to do a whole bunch more stuff.
I'm so pumped!
Honestly, the Detective Prince is a lot better overall. I think she's really cute.
Too cool!
Hmm, interesting.
Says who?
Hmm, interesting. Maybe we should watch that supercut when we get back.
I just remembered.
Well, you'd be surprised at how much money you can make stealing a heart. Yeah, and the price of gold keeps increasing every year.
You.
What, me? Yeah, I've heard of this, actually. I think it's 3 Olympic-sized swimming pools. I mean, that's what I would guess. Okay, this one's more of like an opinion. I'm gonna check the network on this one. Alright, good. Good to know that I was right. Whew!
Correct!
That's interesting. We are never gonna get that knowledge 3 boost, are we?
All right.
It'll take a while. Wow, that's actually a pretty decent chunk.
What did you say?
That's actually super interesting that, like, a whole bunch of landfill-based stuff actually has a bunch of gold wire in it.
Man, the detective from yesterday really pissed me off. Was some kind of threat? Let's see him do it then. If someone else could help him, we wouldn't be doing stuff as the Phantom.
Shut up.
Ow.
You're being way too loud.
Yeah, man. Come on.
Who cares? Everybody's talking about this stuff anyways.
Yeah, but we're not the ones shouting, "We are the Phantom Thieves," in a school full of people trying to figure out who the Phantom Thieves are.
It'd just be more suspicious if we were whispering. Hey, you're really just gonna keep eating and eating and eating those things all by yourself? Give me some!
Sorry, just ate the last one. You guys are too laid back. The police are getting involved now, you know.
Yeah, we should really be taking this a little bit easier.
So you think it's true? We'll be okay if we keep doing this, right?
We can't let the cops scare us out of being Phantom Thieves.
But what about that weird guy from Madarame's palace? Isn't there a lot we don't know?
Hmm.
The hell?
You three seem to be having so much fun. I'm a little jealous.
Are you snooping on us again? We said before, we don't know nothing.
Why do you think I'm here to question you? Could it be that you're hiding something?
Can you just leave us alone?
My ears are always open to the troubles of my peers, you know.
You're really that hungry for a good letter of recommendation?
Of course you are.
Nobody would take on your annoying job if they weren't.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're student council president, right? Wouldn't you have known about Kamoshida?
Of course not. He honestly was a good teacher until that day.
Oh, but you always take the teacher's side. That's what a good council president does, right?
Then how about you? What did you do for your friend? You were much closer to her than I was. So how did you help?
She stayed with her every day in the hospital. That's how she helped.
There wasn't any way to help. By myself, I couldn't do anything for her.
There's no need to shout.
If those Phantom Thieves are out there helping people, I'd root for them, no questions asked. They've gotta be more dependable than some people I know.
Just make sure you show up to your classes, all right?
Maybe we pushed her a little bit far.
You know what I asked earlier? About whether we'll be okay if we keep this up? I take it back. I'd be ashamed to let it end now.
Same.
Hell yeah. It's about time we find our next target, too.
Only I could.
Well, I do feel kind of bad. Though, I didn't say anything.
Comments are coming in at an alarming rate. However, negative ones seem to be more prominent.
Welcome to the internet! This is literally my entire life.
A criminal group with unknown goals that does whatever it wants in the name of justice. Huh.
It's probably because of Akechi. TB's got some crazy sway.
Yeah, it's true.
He's free to deny our actions, but being cursed by his influence is another thing entirely.
Just when we were starting to get people to believe in us, too.
All we gotta do is take down another hotshot, yeah?
Well, do you have any ideas who this next hotshot could be?
I ain't got a thing yet. Damn it, this is really irritating. By the way, what's up with that luggage?
Yeah, it seems like a lot of stuff to be carrying around. Though you are an artist, so I kind of expected it.
Oh, I decided to leave the school dorms.
Wait, what?
You are not only filthy, but too noisy as well. No true art could come from such a place.
Yeah, I understand that feeling. High school dorms are no better, let me tell you.
What are you gonna do then? You can't go back to that shack, right?
Hey dude, you want a room with me?
I was planning on staying at Takamaki-san's, Aunt's house. I've even prepared a thank you gift. I hope it's to your parents' liking.
What? There's no way that's gonna happen.
Impossible.
You're the impossible one.
Yeah, dude, did you really expect her to say yes?
But I spent everything I had on these delectable Japanese sweets.
That's not the issue here. Seriously, though, what are we gonna do about him?
He can bunk with me. What about Ryuji's place? That's actually a good point.
It's way too small. Plus, my folks had never agreed to it.
Well, seeing as Yusuke is an important member of our team, I'll lend a hand. Come stay at our place. It's dirty, but at least you'll have somewhere to sleep.
And I could actually use a roommate. I wouldn't mind it.
Why are you the one calling the shots?
Hey, man. I kind of want somebody to room with.
Don't
who isn't a talking
cafe?
Cat.
I've been wondering about that for a while. Yonken's not too far, is it?
Nope. And the cafe's only a minute walk from the station.
Yeah, it's pretty quick.
How about we go there now? We can have a party to celebrate Madarame's change of heart.
Oh, good idea. We can make it a welcome party for Yusuke, too.
All right, it's decided.
Sorry to cause you trouble.
Nah, don't worry about it, buddy.
By the way, I prefer sleeping on a futon.
Well, you better buy your own. Might want to sell those sweets.
You to convince the chief.
What was that?
What a nice smell.
This place looks so outdated. I can't say I hate it, though.
People refer to that as retro.
Hmm. Who are they?
Hello!
Hey, these are my friends.
A girl, too?
This guy has really helped us a lot lately.
I bet you're the ones doing all the helping.
No, really. He's been great.
Huh. Sit down. This rent will be on the house. You're helping, though.
All right.
Wow. It's delicious.
Hmm. Indeed. There's great depth to its acidity.
Oh, yeah. I remember now. I think I've seen LeBlanc mentioned in a magazine before.
That was a long time ago.
For real? Oh, give me a taste.
Not a coffee guy, I see.
Ah, it's so bitter. Oh, this has got to be cruel and unusual punishment.
I didn't drink coffee when I was a kid either. These are your friends, yeah? Go on and take them up to your room. No need to stay down here.
Ooh, I want to see.
Is this the first time these guys have come to my place?
It's only an attic.
Oh, man. Ah, that bitter taste just won't leave my mouth.
Hey, man, I made that coffee.
Thank you very much for the drink.
Up these stairs. Oh, and thanks for the soda.
So you're,
An. An Takamaki.
An-chan, huh? That's a nice name. You got a boyfriend?
Sojiro, you dog.
Nope. Never have, either.
Hey! You gotta get up here! This place is freaking insane!
Go on.
Oh, right. Thank you for the coffee!
Sheesh. They had to leave the Mona back down here.
The Mona bag.
Sweet girl.
Keep it in your pants, Sojiro. Can't teach an old dog new tricks after all.
What do you think of this room? I don't know where to begin.
It seems quite ordinary to me.
For real?
Well, for you, maybe. You lived in a shack after all.
Oh!
See? Ain't this crazy?
It's cleaner than I thought it would be.
Hey, I try to keep this place nice and neat.
What?
Well, sit wherever you'd like.
We're all over the news. Even those who previously believed in us have been influenced by the comments made on TV.
This is all that effing Akechi's fault!
Keep it down. We don't want anyone hearing us.
At this rate, we're just going to worry everyone instead of give them courage.
Man, Ryuji is a little bit like me. I have this habit of being really loud when I get excited.
We need to find a way to make our rightfulness known to society.
So maybe we need an especially evil target.
It's time we think about our next move. You were planning on discussing that today, right?
Yes. First, we need to search for a candidate.
It's not like we're just gonna stumble upon some important target, though. You guys don't know anyone, do you?
I don't.
Me neither.
What do you think, leader?
Well, I've got some ideas. Well, how about the news? Anything interesting?
Well, there probably are a lot of famous targets on TV.
However, the suspects on the news are already being pursued by the police. Even if we make them confess their crimes, the police will take the credit. That won't do.
True.
Damn it. Never gonna prove a Akechi wrong at this rate.
What the?
The heck was that?
Sorry. I haven't eaten anything since yesterday.
Jeez, you really are a starving artist.
And you spent all your money on that box of sweets?
Dude, how much did you have?
Anyway, we'll just have to sit tight until we can find another target. So, how about that welcome party?
We could use some food.
Someone's excited.
I think I found something. Isn't that a portable stove? Can't we make hot pot on it?
Ooh, interesting.
That sounds great. I've heard that eating hot pot together brings people closer.
Anything with meat's fine by me.
Yeah, man, same here.
I only ask that we finish it off with porridge. Extra parsley, of course.
So, what do you say?
Sounds good to me.
Okay, hot pot it is.
Sounds like fun.
Come on, let's go buy ingredients.
Well, I'll need ginkgo nuts, wonton wrappers, and...
We'll take care of the shopping. Could you borrow a pot from downstairs while we're out? We can split the cost later.
Yeah, sure.
Looks like this
got that pan flute, though.
Going to turn out quite lively. We should go grab that pot and set up the portable stove too.
Man, I could really go for some pot. Okay, that was a bad pun. I apologize. All right then. Where's our portable stove here, anyway? Yeah, whatever. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. You want to join us? What do you say to that? Oh, sure. Thanks. Where could it be? All right. Oh, here it is. Or maybe not. Okay. All right, you got it. Don't worry. I promise we won't burn the house down. This time.
And now, on to the hottest meet and greet segment of our show. After his last appearance was so well received, we decided to bring back this fine gentleman today.
No, these two are related. I don't know why that didn't register in my brain.
It's the high school detective, Goro Akechi.
This tastes a bit bland, but I'm relieved. A lot's happened, but it seems your grades haven't dropped.
School's been going fine. I'm more worried about you, sis. Are you tired? You're probably lacking sodium.
Do I seem so?
But hypothetically speaking, if these phantom thieves are real, I believe they should be tried in a court of law.
That's quite the statement. Are they committing crimes? Some people even say that the thieves are actually helping their victims abandon their evil ways.
What the artist Madarame did truly was an unforgivable crime. However, they're taking the law into their own hands by judging him. It is far from justice. More importantly, you should never forcefully change a person's heart.
Is it a crime to manipulate someone's heart? Depending on the means, yes. He's absolutely right.
Even if it makes someone admit their evil deeds and helps make them pay for their crimes?
Why the sudden interest?
It's nothing.
Do you believe that these allies of justice exist?
Of course not.
You don't need to think about such unnecessary things. You understand what I'm trying to say, right?
Study hard and go to a prestigious college.
Moving up in the world is difficult as a woman. Yet you can't do much if you don't have the authority. I'll use every method necessary to make it happen. All you need to do is remain focused on what must be done now for your future's sake.
Sorry.
Now. Yes? Mm-hmm, it's fine.
You know what I've been wondering? What happens if somebody gets thrown into their own palace? Sorry, maybe this is off topic. I'll bring this up another time. But honestly, the internal conflict she's having, I guess anybody else would have that.
Oh, that case.
What must be done? Justice.
If those phantom thieves are out there helping people, I'd root for them, no questions asked.
What do I want to do?
It's true. Like I said before, you can't have somebody else dictate your life.
Oh, I can't eat another bite.
Because only you are living it.
That was delicious, Lady An. I'm sure you'll make a wonderful bride some...
Sorry. I'm gonna have to borrow the sofa.
It's fine. You pervs.
What's wrong, Yusuke?
We haven't finished our meal. What about the porridge? Or even udon?
Just leave it for next time, man.
You guys tired?
She's asleep already?
It'd be weird if she wasn't tired. We should let her sleep.
By the way, Ryuji, how do you know An?
Huh? Oh, we went to middle school together.
You two actually seem pretty close, considering.
What was Lady An like back then?
Not so different from now.
Once we got to high school, we ended up in different classes and stopped talking. I don't think she had many friends. I mean, she grew up overseas. Plus, there's her looks. The popular kids hate her, the quiet ones stay away.
I see. So, what about you two?
Us?
This is a great opportunity to get to know each other better.
That's true.
You know every detail of my past at this point. It's only fair you tell me every detail of yours.
Alright, if you want to know.
So you got nothing to lose, huh? Alright, I'll tell you. It's just a normal story about a rotten kid, though. My dad left when I was young. Ever since then, it's just been me and my mom. I was actually trying to get a track scholarship so I could make things easier for her. In the end, I just screwed it all up. Turns out I'm a pretty bad son, huh?
I don't agree. I think you're a pretty good guy.
Back when I was a first year, my mom got called out to school for me raising my hand at Kamoshida. All the teachers kept hounding her for what I did, but she just stayed quiet through it all. I'll never forget the look she had on her face, though. On the way home, she apologized to me for being a single mom and all.
Dude, I'm so sorry.
So that's what happened. They say at school that everyone is equal, but in reality, that's a gross oversimplification. I understand how you feel.
Well, when it comes to getting labeled, nobody's got it worse than this guy.
Yeah.
Is this about his past?
Yeah, I'm pretty much the only one here with a criminal record.
Now that I think about it, we never have heard the details.
I mean, if you guys want to know.
Damn brat! I'll sue!
It is that guy, I think.
If you keep this up, then I'll report about the money. Is that fine with you?
All I have to say is that you did it on your own. And it's over.
But I just did as I was told.
Who do you think I am?
No!
Hey, make this statement to the cops. This kid suddenly attacked me. Got it? If you even try to say anything else, you know what'll happen to you, right?
Huh? But...
Dude, this is bullshit.
Shut up. You're done for.
Fuck you.
Learn what happens when you cross me.
I really should just deck you at this point.
Excuse me, folks. We received a complaint about an argument here. Is something the matter? Oh, it's you, sir.
So what happened? Explain it to the good officer.
That young man suddenly attacked him. He shoved this gentleman to the ground, and this man got injured.
What?
It's as she says. Also, make sure you deal with this so my name isn't mentioned at all. You understand what that means, correct?
Yes, sir. Hey, cuff him. Understood.
Hey, man, I didn't do jack shit.
Just listening to it pisses me off. God damn it! You got an assault on your record just for that.
The woman sounds quite horrible as well. She stayed quiet this whole time.
Honestly, I don't know her reasons.
That man is just the kind of person whose heart we should steal. Who is he? And where can we find him?
I'll never know his name.
You can't remember, huh? Well, it was at night, and I'm sure you were in shock after getting arrested. I understand all too well the pain of not being able to remember important details of your life.
The victim's personal information is always kept secret. Identifying that man will prove difficult. Besides, the courts already made their ruling, didn't they?
But they could always go back on it.
Even if we manage to get revenge, his past record won't go away.
I can't stand it! This world is so messed up! The weak are left to fight for themselves while rotten adults get away with whatever they want!
And those in power don't do anything to help the situation.
Can't we fix this, though? Nobody would even know. We just need to show the world what true justice is. We'll make them come to their senses.
You're right, Yusuke. That's gotta be what our powers are for.
Sounds good to me. The flashier our missions are, the cooler we end up looking.
True. I agree. I can't change my past, but I know I can make a brighter future.
You've all taught me so much.
God, that sounded so cheesy, though.
What are you guys getting all excited about?
Oh, sorry. Did we wake you up?
Nah, not really. I've been up for a while now. Still, this weird feeling came over me while I was listening to you guys. It almost feels like I've known you all forever. Do you think it's because our backgrounds are so similar?
Well, it sure ain't because of anything good.
True.
Similar, huh? I'm the only one who doesn't fit in.
Hmm?
I don't have any past to look back on. No memories.
You don't really need them.
What do you mean? We could search the whole world and we wouldn't find a bigger misfit than you. And the reason we're going to Mementos is to get your memories back, right?
I'm sure your past will be just as troubled as ours.
Yeah.
No doubt.
We'll see about that.
I actually feel like I've known Morgana for a really long time, too. It's so strange. I can't really put it into words.
We've got a genuine connection, us four, five.
Look, I'm helping you guys out for my own sake. Don't get me wrong, if you don't get stronger, investigating Mementos won't be anything but a pipe dream.
Oh, calm down, you little cat.
That sure was a quick turnaround. One second you're depressed, the next you're acting all tough.
Eh, you gotta be tough to be a leader, right?
All joking aside, let's take this seriously. We should go as far with it as we can.
Yeah.
I want to punish those corrupt adults and give courage to people in trouble. Only we can do that.
Ha! You can say that again.
Being a member of the Phantom Thieves will surely help me grow, both as an artist and as a person.
I agree.
Of course. You're under my tutelage, after all. There's nothing we can't accomplish.
Well, I hope we can keep this up. We should be all right with you as our leader.
Well then, leave it to me.
Whoa, it's this late?
I guess now's a good time to call it for the night.
Yeah, sure. Sounds good to me. We have been doing this for quite a while.
Oh, that reminds me. The owner said you're free to crash here, Yusuke.
That's very kind of him.
He's a pretty good guy. Just don't get on his bad side.
You convinced him, didn't you? You go, Miss Older Dude Charmer.
What kind of nickname is that?
A terrible one.
I won't be able to sleep unless I take a bath.
There's a bathhouse nearby, so you can go there. I won't be able to join you, though.
Oh, that sounds great. I want to come, too. How about you, Juan?
You guys go on ahead. I should get going.
Yeah, she does live a little far from us.
Well, good night, Morgana.
Damn it. I need to turn back into a human soon. I can't let her get taken by someone else.
You know I'm gonna try and steal her from you. If you keep talking like that. Nah, Anne's not my type. Though I do really like her.
Huge bathtubs really are the best. An's missing out.
It's a bit hot, though.
Old guys like it hot for some reason. I'm sure he'll stop eventually. You know, I've been wondering for a while now, but what do you think about An? As a girl, I mean.
I mean, she's pretty breathtaking, I must admit.
Oh, you straight up said it. Well, in her case, her looks totally make up for her overbearing personality.
I'll be sure to share what you've said with An.
Hey man, this is guy talk, don't you dare.
Oh, please don't. Seriously?
That aside, we need to hurry and find our next target.
About that though, is targeting famous people enough? Seeing people's reactions these days has been making me think twice about what we do.
True. Pursuing only what's best in the short term may end up becoming fruitless for us. We need a strategy to appeal to the public.
Oh? What do you got in mind?
Do I look like someone who could come up with such a thing?
Well, you are a smart cookie. I'll give you that much for free.
I was an idiot for asking.
We need a plan.
I'm more like the charge commander, and Morgana's a specialist of that world.
He's also a tool specialist.
Still.
We really could use the brains of the operation. Ryuji's the muscle. Yosuke's the eyes. An's the beauty. Morgana's the experience. And me, I guess I'm just all of the above.
It's freaking hot! How much do you have to add until you're satisfied, Gramps? I can't stand it anymore!
Anyways, let's meet up again early next week. I'll contact everyone.
Later, guys. Oh, hey. I guess Yosuke's staying with us now. Do we have an extra futon for him? I don't actually know. Let's talk to him.
Did something happen?
Oh, I guess that makes sense. It's fine if he wants to crash on the couch. I mean, we could work on the desk. Yeah, let's just go to bed, I think. But before that... You know, this might be a good time to end off the episode. It might be a little bit early, but I don't know what's going to be coming up next, so...
I'll just add this.
Let's save right now. Wow, I've already gotten twice over, huh? Eh, it'll be fine. I'll end off here, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. So, see you guys in the next one. Later, everybody.